Bonjour, hi! Welcome to another video of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, and today I want to show you how to deploy our ARM template with the Azure DevOps. In a previous video, I show you how to deploy a web app using the Azure DevOps, and I was using the Azure DevOps repos. But a lot of time, our code is in GitHub, since it's a very popular repository. So today, I want to show you how to use GitHub as code source for your deployment. So here, just like the other day, I have a Frank Demo ASP.NET MVC web app. But this time, I got it in a GitHub repository. So we'll use this repository in our deployment inside Azure DevOps. So to get started, let's go in Azure DevOps, and we'll go in pipeline, we'll create a new build pipeline. Last time we used the Azure repos, but this time we'll use GitHub. Because it's the first time I'm trying to connect to my GitHub repository, Azure DevOps need to be authorized. So we'll do that by clicking the authorize button. And now I just need to select the repository I want to target. So Frank Demo. Perfect. Now, just like last time, it asks me, it detects that my repository contains an ASP.NET Core website, so we'll use that as a template. Excellent. And now, just like last time, we got the Azure Pipeline YAML file. And we know that this is good enough for the build, but not good enough for a deployment. So we'll add here the next task in my file, and I will save and run it. This will add the YAML file at the root of my folder. So while this is building, let's think about the next step. In the previous video, I was showing you how to deploy, and I was using Azure CLI command to create the website. Of course, in a real DevOps process, we don't use manual steps. The best practice will be to use an ARM template. So let's add an ARM template to our code. So we'll go back in Visual Studio Code. And since I had a new file in my repository, I will pull the last news to get latest and greatest. And now I have my Azure pipeline. Perfect. Now we'll add a new Azure deploy JSON file. While I'm there, I will also add a new parameter file. I won't use it for this demo, but it's always a very good practice to have it, so I will show you how to have it. Excellent. Since I won't use a parameter file for this demo, we'll keep it for another one. We'll just add like an empty parameter file. Now, for the ARM template, we need to create one. So we know that to deploy a website, we need two things. We need, of course, the website and a plan, a service plan, so always. So let's create an ARM template containing those two things. So first, we'll create an ARM template. And now in the resources, I will add another one. So ARM and then plan, plan, just like that. I will call it Frank Demo Plan. Excellent. And you know what? I'll keep that in my clipboard and add another one. So now I need to create an ARM web app, just like this. And because I'm not using a suffix, I will just create a Frank Demo and add something at the end, so I'm sure it's unique. So a best practices will be to use a suffix here. But since I want to do it quick, I'm just using 4242. In the next video, I will show you how to include all those things as you're deploying. So, and for the service plan, I use Frank Demo Plan. Perfect. Now, we save it and we push it. Great, now it's time to implement our release pipeline. So as we can see here, the build was successful. That's excellent, and now we'll create a new release. So we'll go in release and we'll create a new pipeline. Perfect, I'm deploying an app service deployment. We'll use that as a template. And just like last time, I will put to Azure, but you put something that is meaningful for you. Excellent. So we'll use the build because I want the package that just got built by Frank Demo, and I will use my Frank Demo. I want the last version, and I will call this drops. And I want that to be triggered every time we commit. We have our drops, so we have our build, but we don't have access yet to our template or arm template. So I want to create another artifact that will point to my GitHub repository. To do that, we need to click on the plus here, and we had a new artifact. So instead of using the build, I will use GitHub. Now I need to click which one I want to use. It was F. Boucher, the one I declare at the beginning, and I need to use the repository. So here it lists all the repository, and I just need to scroll. They are in alphabetic order. I just need to scroll until I have Frank Demo just there. I will be using master and everything, and I will change here the name of the source alias to GitHub drops. So now I have two artifacts. So we'll go here and define our things. So now, of course, I need to specify the Azure subscription. Nothing new here. And then I will need to authorize it. And now I need to specify the app name. So a smart way here will be to use variables or use the template. But for now, I'm just hard coding everything. But right now we are deploying, but we should create our resources. So to do this, we need to add another step, another task. So we'll click here on the plus. And if you search for resource, you should find the Azure Resource Group deployment. That's what we want. So we'll make sure this one is first because we need to deploy the ARM template and then deploy the code inside of it. Perfect. So now I need to define my ARM template, and this is the new thing. So the subscription, I still need to specify the subscription, right? So we'll just pick the same as the other one. So now the action I want to create or update. The resource group, let's call it cloud 5 minutes. Location, whoops, I'm typing too fast today. Cloud 5 minutes, and I will use a location east to west. This is a resource group that will be used in my deployment. So now it's the part where I define my template. So I will use the linked artifact, and because I created an artifact previously, I could go here and see I have now my GitHub drops. So I could expand this and use my Azure deploy.json file just here. This. So I use that, I click OK. And now my deployment will use that file as a reference. The same thing for a parameter file. For us, it's empty, but still, just want to show you that how to do it. So here, the parameter. So because here I'm doing a simple demo, I'm not doing any validation, but it will be a good practice to add another step just before this one to just do a validation. So here I could deploy mode and say validation only, and that will validate my ARM template with my parameter file. This way, if for example the name already exists, or if I have some typo in the JSON file, my deployment will fail at that level. It will be much faster, and then I could fix it and redeploy. For now, I will use only incremental. So I have everything I need, I think. Yes, I can save. And now it's time to create a release. Create a release to Azure. Release one was created. Let's go there and deploy it. Perfect. Of course, in the usual way will be to have a new build that will trigger my release. But since you know the build was already done, that's why we're doing it manually. So I'll get back to you just after. There it is, already finished. So let's go in our portal, Azure portal, and see if I have a new resource group. Yes, I have, of course. Now we'll go open it. We have our Frank Demo 4242 website created. And now we go on the website and it's working. If I go, I forgot the about. Yeah, your application was in GitHub. And voila, it works. Whatever your code is in GitHub, Azure DevOps, or another repository, it's very easy to use it with the Azure DevOps pipelines. I hope you liked this video and I hope it was useful. Every second week, I publish short video to answer technical questions. So if you have a question, just ask it in the comment section. You don't miss any of the other videos. Subscribe and click the bell icon. Thank you for watching. See you next time. I wonder if they noticed my new t-shirt.